Copy-pasting genes, the origin of new genetic information by gene duplication. Opponents of the modern theory of evolution, i.e. creationists and ID supporters, often argue that mutations do not add new information to the genome of any organism. This criticism has the very real potential to destroy evolutionary theory if it were correct. If evolution is to be used as a scientific explanation for the diversity of life on Earth, then it has to account for the increase in genetic information over the last few billion years. And if evolution is incapable of meeting this demand, then the theory would be falsified. Unfortunate for the creationists, their criticism is invalid. Evolution can and does produce new information in a very simple way. In fact, this method predicts that we find characteristic footprints that we can detect in the genomes of various organisms. Mutation is the engine of evolution. The process of mutation is responsible for introducing variations within a genome by imperfectly replicating the original DNA sequence. However, a mutation in an important gene in most cases leads to a loss of function. An example of this is p53. p53 is a tumor suppressor protein that maintains DNA repair, induces cell cycle arrest, or apoptosis, controlled cell death, whenever the integrity of the genome has been lost because of DNA damage. In essence, p53 prevents cells with damaged DNA from dividing. A mutation in p53 often leads to a loss of all of these functions and can ultimately lead to uncontrolled cell division and subsequently cancer. Strong conservative selection pressures prevent a mutated gene like a mutated p53 gene from propagating throughout a population by negatively selecting those individuals with a dysfunctional gene. Gene duplication is needed to allow propagation of a mutated gene. Gene duplication simply involves copying a gene, in this example, gene A. The newly duplicated gene can then be subject to a variety of mutations and the original gene won't be affected, thus preserving the original function. The copy gene can diverge rapidly from the original because, unlike its parent gene, it is not subject to selective pressures that force the gene to maintain function. The original gene A maintains its function because of the conservative selection pressures acting upon it. The copy gene, however, can do either of two things. One, it acquires too many deleterious mutations and degenerates into a non-functional pseudogene, designated Psi A. Or two, it will acquire mutations that lead to a difference in expression or a different property that is considered advantageous and become a new gene, designated A2. This new gene A2 will have a related function to the original gene A. Duplicated genes will give rise to complex genomes and can do so quite quickly. Estimates in a study carried out by Lynch and Conery in 2000 state that the average gene undergoes duplication once every 100 million years. This may not seem very quick, but let me demonstrate a little calculation. If we were to start off with one gene at 3.5 billion years ago, and if a gene duplication takes place once every 100 million years, then today we would have almost 35 billion genes. While it's not entirely certain how many different genes exist in the entire world, this rate is quick enough to account for the huge amount of variation in genes. Earlier I mentioned finding characteristic footprints within the genomes of various organisms that can tell us gene duplication has taken place. The process of gene duplication leaves behind two distinctive marks. One, duplicated genes often have a related function to the original gene. And two, duplicated genes are often found close together in the genome. Do we really find these characteristics? The answer is yes, and a perfect example is the globin superfamily. Globins are proteins that bind oxygen and are therefore very important in the respiratory system. Hemoglobin, here shown in green and red, is a well-known and well-studied example. It is the protein responsible for the oxygen-binding property of blood and is found in red blood cells. But there serves as an oxygen transporter in muscle tissues. And then there are neuroglobin and cytoglobin. Although the function of cytoglobin has remained obscure since its recent discovery, both cytoglobin and neuroglobin share a homologous relationship with hemoglobin and myoglobin. When we take a closer look at one particular gene cluster, the human beta globin gene cluster, we can reconstruct its history throughout several species back to a single gene. Here you can see a part of that reconstructed history, limited to a few species. As you can see, the amount of tweaking done in the last 150 million years can give rise to a wide variety of new and functional genes throughout several related species. Apart from gene duplication, gene conversion and inactivation also take place. Gene conversion is the exchange of a sequence from one gene with a sequence from another. An example of this in the human cluster are the beta and delta genes. The beta gene has replaced a part of the delta gene sequence with a part of its own. The variety of different globin proteins provide benefits at different developmental stages and subsequently became more and more specialized in their function. In this video, I hope to have demonstrated that new information can and has been added by evolution. By mutating duplicated genes, a new gene with a related function to the original gene can arise. I've also shown you that mutations in the duplicated gene can go awry and lead to the formation of non-functioning pseudogenes. This process leaves behind certain footprints that we can see, and an example of a gene cluster found by looking at those prints is the Globin superfamily. The criticism we discussed made by the opponents of evolutionary theory would seriously endanger the theory if it were correct. However, as we can see, mutations in natural selection can give rise to new genetic information, and so the criticism maintained by the opponents is invalid, just like many other arguments against evolution. Thanks for watching.